Artanis, Hierarch of the Twilight Council, Warlord of the Templar. I had expected so much more.
Arrogance! Watch your words, or my blade will watch them for you.
Oh, that's hardly a way to speak of one who saved your master's life.
You care little for my survival, Alarak. What is the true reason you've come to me?
Our god broke his ancient covenant and cast us low.
These are lies, Artanis.
I am the liar? Are you not but a lie incarnate machine, Protoss?
Speak your peace, Alarak.
The Tal'Darim's death fleet amasses its slain, awaiting the start of a full-scale invasion. I come with an offer. You will aid me in invoking a challenge for the right to rule my kind as High Lord. And in return, I will grant you a cessation of hostilities between our people.
Phoenix, rally my advisors. It appears we have much to discuss.
Artanis, I believe I will serve you more effectively from here. Besides, I would rather Alarak remain where he can be watched.
Nothing was as it seemed. We came to Ulnar to awaken the Zelnaga and receive their aid. Instead, Amon nearly killed us. I fear Zeratul's prophecy is no longer clear to me.
He was closer to the truth than I thought. The Zelnaga did rest here. Had they lived, I think they would have given us their aid, just as Zeratul said. If nothing else, I will grant him that.
Matriarch, your words surprise me.
Perhaps your council has proved influential in some regards.
Then I will endeavor to give you more of it.
I said some regards, Hierarch. Not all.
I said some regards, not all.
Rohanna, do you not see why you must sever your nerve cords? I cannot allow you to fall under Amon's sway again.
The collar was created in our darkest moment. Only its light was able to bind our people to give us unity. We are born into it, and when we die, our spirits become one with it. It is worth fighting for.
And now Amon uses it against us. It sustains his existence. Its time must end.
Artanis, through the collar, our every thought and emotion are made as one. I feel his thoughts and emotions swirling like a vortex throughout. He does not realize it, but here, within the collar, he is vulnerable.
How?
Just as he can see into me, I can see into him. We can use this to our advantage, Hierarch. I know it.
It is not worth it.
Please, I only ask for time.
Well, I hope so. Okay.
Powerful psionic warriors have joined our ranks, Hierarch. You must choose among them.
Psionic warrior, high temper, dark warrior. Oh. Yep. Permanently take control of enemy units. Forces enemy units to attack each other. Attack ground and air units. They're pretty useful. Yep. Can I still take control of enemy SCVs, enemy drones to make their own building stuff? I would try that. Yeah. Besides, I don't really use high temper as much anyway. I like the dark archons.
New Tal'Darim robotics have been constructed based on Alarak's specifications. Let us hope his instructions were thorough.
Havoc. Increases damage dealt to enemy units, boosts attack range friendly units, force field blocks ground unit movement, cannot attack. They're pretty useful though. But I prefer energizer since they can transform to generate power field, and they also boost attack and movement speed of friendly units. Yep. That's fine, that means it's solar core.
Hyrok, I believe I have found a way to save our people. As Zeratul foresaw, this keystone can indeed be our salvation.
Explain yourself.
As we have seen, the keystone was designed to be found and assembled by those who would ascend to become Zelnaga. After leading them to Ulnar, it would also expel its stored energy to awaken the slumbering Zelnaga. The keystone siphons energies and redistributes essence, matter, information, consciousness to this device. They are all the same. I see that now.
This is how it cleansed Kerrigan.
It extracted the essence that forged her into the Queen of Blades. Then it used that energy to release Amon from the void. If I can discover how to control the keystone, we could use it to extract Amon from the Kala and save our people.
Then Zeratul has led us to hope after all. Continue your research, Kerax. We have a war to take to Amon.
Huh? Great discovery, I suppose. Phoenix.
You were right all along, Hierarch. I am little more than a clone of your friend, Phoenix. The Tal'Darim speaks truth. I am synthetic. A replication. A lie.
What did you find in the archive?
My death. My rebirth as a Dragoon. And then, my death at the hands of this Queen of Blades. I am not Phoenix, yet I hold his memories as if they were my own. I must have time to consider this.
You are a warrior, Phoenix. Whether you identify yourself as my old friend or not, know that I believe in you. And I believe you will help me destroy Amon's armies and save our people. Do not waver because of this knowledge.
I will try, Hierarch.
To try, Phoenix. Let's see, 15 more. Even if I do this, I still won't have enough for the broken. Gotta get more. In other news, I can maximize all of this, which is great too. Okay, let's go to the mission. Let's talk to Arlena.
You must know Amon will destroy you.
If you have such faith in him, why are you here?
Oh, I merely voice the inevitable. I know the true power of what you face. I said destroy you, not I.
I have seen enough. His hubris will be his undoing. It is a flaw I also see in you.
I believe I like you, Hierarch. Your bravery is commendable.
Join me then. Together, we can defeat him.
I cannot tether my fate to yours. Hatred does not burn within you as it does in me. You do not see through the agony of knowing all you believed in is a lie, and that your only solace is found in the destruction of your betrayer.
No. Amon corrupted my people, and now turns them into a hybrid abomination. My rage burns brighter than 1,000 suns, and soon all will see my wrath unleashed!
Then this is something I hope to witness.
Huh. Okay, let's go to the War Council. Oh, let's go to that indeed. Short time later.
The void portal within Ulnar has been sealed. But a greater threat looms. Amon is transforming our people into a host form.
While we were focused upon Ulnar, he has unleashed the full might of the Golden Armada, using our own weaponry to eradicate life from planets across the Kaprulu sector.
Our current forces are not powerful enough to engage the Great Fleet, but Amon's other servants run rampant across the sector.
Then we should strike immediately. Eliminate his outlying forces.
The ancient purifiers were designed for war. If we reactivate them, we can build our armies and destroy Amon's Zerg broods in one fell swoop.
Assuming they do not turn on us first. The Purifiers possess no loyalty, no honor.
You waste time bickering. The Tal'Darim's death fleets are your threat. I alone can challenge Malash for the right to rule and bend his army to my will.
Do not forget Mobius Corps. They are rumored to operate from a hidden base where they forge a hybrid army to serve, even now.
This is true, but we cannot engage them without knowing where they are. Vorazun, send your most elite Dark Templar to scour the sector. For now, Kerax, your focus must remain with the Keystone. The survival of our people depends on our actions in the days to come. It falls to the Firstborn to stop the coming Oblivion.
Endion and Slain, huh? Let's see Endion.
The Zelnaga are dead. There is no salvation within Ulnar. And yet, we indeed found hope. If we are to fight, we must raise an army. Phoenix and I believe that we can awaken the ancient purifiers and call upon their power. They may have been a forbidden weapon, but I have seen their potential in Phoenix and know that this time, they will not fail us.
Oh, and I can also get Colossus' powerful battle strider. Can walk up and down cliffs, attack, incinerate multiple enemies once. This is great. I like using Colossus whenever I can. Slaying is probably the main mission, so I will do the side mission first. And also I can get the Colossus, so yep.
I have made a decision many of you will not agree with. During my time with Phoenix, I have seen that the Purifier program, under the right guidance, may be reborn.
History has shown the Purifiers cannot be controlled, Artanis.
They do not have to be. These personalities, like I, will have free will.
We do not have enough Purifier matrices to create more like Phoenix.
You cannot possibly be considering what I think you are.
The original Purifiers are housed in orbit above the forest world of Endion, sealed within their warship, Cybros. I have seen, through Phoenix, that these warriors may be valuable to us. Perhaps the Conclave misunderstood them, treating them as simple robots and not proud Templar. It tried to control them.
And they rebelled, attacking their creators.
Would you not rebel against a slave master?
I have heard your counsel, and I have chosen to go to Endion. We leave at once!
Okay, Artanis.
The Purifier stasis grid is still intact. We'll have to destabilize it from the generator below. I'm detecting a massive Zerg infestation on the surface. They can't be Kerrigan's.
Amon's brood. This will not be easy.
Zerg, huh? Again. War Council, no conversation.
Hierarch, my scouts are tracking the movements of the Golden Armada.
Okay, good job, Vorazun.
What you plan to do is awaken monsters, Artanis. They slaughtered every Templar on the base of Lantinum.
They rose against their masters. Our people never treated them as Templar.
Because they are robots, created to do the bidding of the Conclave.
Is this what you think of Phoenix? A robot whose only purpose is to do your bidding?
He certainly defies expectations. He is more.
Perhaps the original Purifier robots will be too. If nothing else, think of their benefit to the war effort.
That is, if they choose to join us.
I believe in Phoenix. I am willing to take the risk.
Yep. Your conversation.
The Zerg posed quite a problem. Disrupting the stasis grid was never going to be easy. It certainly will be less so with Amon's brood attacking us.
We will hold them off long enough for your work, Kerax.
The scientists sealed away Cybros with a device called the Megalith. It is the key to disabling the station's stasis lock. Once the grid is down, we have to act swiftly and bring Cybros online or flee orbit. The might of the brood below is too great.
Leave the defense to me.
I know this will work, Hierarch. I know I can guide the Purifiers through the darkness that lies ahead. Help them accept what they are. I can convince them that they will not be treated as servants again.
Then it appears as if you have found purpose, brother.
Since awakening, I have been confused, directionless, uncertain of what I am, how I came to be. Now, things are clear once more. Fate has laid out a purpose only I can accomplish. It is exhilarating.
Yes. You embark upon a task that even Phoenix could not achieve.
Yet he would attempt it if he could. I have learned much from Phoenix's memories, and through them, I have come to know myself. I am Phoenix, but not. I am my own entity, and I take pride in this.
Good. That's good, Phoenix. Okay, so let's go to the mission. Welcome back.
The shield emitters on Endion must be disabled if we are to reactivate Cybros. The time to begin is now, Hierarch.
Seal all caves with rocks in the Unsealing the past mission less than 40 seconds after Zerg begin to emerge from them. Unsealing the past, disable stasis locks. Okay, let's go. Let's see if we can get that achievement. Some units can attack multiple targets at once. This makes them effective against large groups of enemies, especially Zerg, like the Colossi. Yep, they're big, they can walk up and down cliffs, and they attack multiple units, making in there also making them burn. This is pretty cool looking. They would be being very good in the Brood War, but yeah. New from StarCraft II.
Cybros, the vault of the Purifiers. It is fortunate that Amon's brood has been unable to penetrate its stasis grid.
I now have access to Endion's records. The stasis grid is sealed by complicated locking mechanisms. They can only be destabilized by a certain device, the Megalith. I'll begin recovering it now, so it may work on the locks.
It will need protection. These forests already crawl with Zerg abominations.
Then we shall clear them out.
If I may, Hierarch, this facility once developed powerful weapons for the Empire.
I have heard tale of the mighty Colossi, scaling cliffs, besieging enemies from afar. Let us see how they fare against the Zerg.
Oh, first thing I already come across. Okie dokie. Yep, pretty good. They attack from far away from the defense. This thingy. Attack the area again.
The Zerg are coming from that cave. If we fire on the rock formation, it will seal the opening.
Nice. That's pretty epic attack for lasers. They attack from far away too. I destroyed this thing going. They are ugly. Very good. They cannot attack my follow fight. Nice. Magalith. Well, this base is mine, you know.
Well done. The area is secure. Warp coordinates for our nexus point are locked. Kerax, activate the megalith.
Authorization in progress. The megalith should be ready shortly, Hierarch. We will monitor its status and alert you when it is online.
Okay. We start with three colossi and three cells.
The megalith systems will take a few moments to activate. It will be ready to move out soon. In the meantime, I've upgraded our robotics facilities to construct colossi. You can warp them in whenever you wish, Hierarch.
Cool. I can make more colossi. There's a Zerg thingy here. Can I just come down here? Well, they barely do any damage to my unit. Yeah, with my Colossi I can just stop. What is this? No idea. But well, there are no Zerg here anymore. I think with just the Colossi I can do a lot of stuff.
The megalith should be finishing up shortly. We should ensure that we have enough forces to defend it.
Yeah, we should. Let's build more colossi first. Let's see. Yeah. Let's keep going. Oh yeah. There's extra resources here. Oh, and there's a restaurant vesping gas there. Let's go here. They won't be able to attack us from here anyway.
The megalith is online. We must ensure it reaches the stasis locks safely.
There, they can't reach us now. 3000 health. Let's build more colossi.
You have not enough minerals.
Oh, what's this megalith? Then there's another one here. Let's go here though. Let's see.
The megalith has reached the first stasis lock. It will be safe below the surface as it does its work.
Good job. Yeah, mostly completing the mission with just the Zergs. With just the Colossi, I mean. Let's send the Colossi here, and here, and here, and here.
Your warriors have engaged the enemy.
Yeah, they barely do damage against my Colossi. Oh, there's a hive here.
I'm detecting Zerg movement. Warriors, ensure none reach our nexus point. Your warriors have engaged the enemy.
Send them here. Okie dokie, we have enough. Let's get more colossi. Well, if we had the pylons sufficient for it, that is. Let's build a lot of pylons.
The megalith is almost done with this lock. I would advise you to make preparations for its next move.
Okie dokie. Let's build the fort. Since we don't have it, let's get more gateways too. Do I have yeah, I have a cybernetics core, so So let's get the Dark Templar thingy. Okay, that's enough for now. Oops.
Sensors show the first stasis lock has been disabled. The megalith is relocating to the next one.
Okay.
The canyon grows narrow ahead. Crawlers, they're rooting on the ridge. Brace for incoming fire.
Destroy them. There are lots around them. Oh, what's this? Ultra Risk. Well, it barely does damage my Colossi. Was of no matter. Oh, a queen.
The Megalith has arrived safely at the second stasis lock. It shall be brought down shortly.
Interesting. I believe this facility used power cores of incredible size to provide energy for experiments. They should be hidden somewhere within these hills. If our warriors can destroy them, we can claim the solarite components within.
That seems to be nice. Let's warp in some sentry energizer, rather. I don't really need lots of... Oh. Let's see, is there anything here? Well, it's just another path. Let's go here then.
Ever vigilant. Eternally resolute.
Oh, wow, okay. There. That's enough. Nice. Good job, guys. There, I got 10 Solarites. There's another more. There's more Solarites back there. Is there anything else here? No, just a path to go here.
The Megalith's work is nearly complete. It will move again soon.
Okie dokie. Let's get a lot of dragons.
I have returned.
And some zealots to attack the base. Okay, let's go back here. We're gonna see what's in here. There's a hive here, otherwise I don't know what else is there. Oh, good thing they were coming to attack me, huh? Let's get more Colossi. Oh, what's this? Oh, what is it going to move to?
Stasis lock disabled, and the grid is now at 60%. The megalith is en route to the third lock.
Yeah,
now.
I was going to go there, okay. But now I have to go this way instead. Let's see. Get more dragons. Nice.
I have returned.
Oh, they're attacking the overlords. Let's send in the Colossi first. Yes, very good. Very good. Well, Zealots are attacking them, but no matter. Good job, guys. That was easy enough. Let's send the Colossi up here and get the other... get more Solarites. Meanwhile, let's upgrade our stuff.
Well done, warriors. The Megalith is disabling the third lock.
Well, that was my mistake, you know.
Both power cores have been obtained. I'll begin working on them immediately.
Destabilizing stasis lock. Okay, let's make more. Well, we already have a lot of units. Okay, let's attack.
I am detected. detecting a large number of Zerg bioforms in the cave network ahead.
We can use the terrain to our advantage. Topple the rock formations near the entrance and seal the Zerg within the caves.
Okay. There's a lot of Zerg here. Okay, let's attack.
A significant number of Zerg here have been detected in the caves ahead. Exercise caution.
Nice. Let's go, guys. Let's destroy them. Let's destroy this rock formation first, though. Nice. Oh. Well then. Some of my units got trapped. GG. No matter, though. Oh, another rocker thingy.
This lock is almost destabilized. The megalith will relocate shortly.
There is an entire Zerg hive cluster between the megalith and the last stasis lock. Our only option is to fight through it.
Okie dokie, let's warp in some more units. Yeah. Complete. Let's see, what shall we get? More zealots, probably. And yeah, a few dragons. There. And more of them are coming. Oh, what's this? Oh, okay.
The third lock has been disabled, and the megalith is on the move. My readout shows Cybros beginning to awaken from stasis. Only two remain, Hierarch.
Let's destroy them. Nice, nice. Very good. Let's destroy Zerg base completely.
Disturbance detected.
What?
Nidus worms are inbound on your location.
Oh, okay. Nidus worms. Where? Oh, there, okay. Let's destroy the sphere.
Phase link authorized. The megalith is now disabling the fourth lock.
Well, that was easy enough. There.
Our blades meet the enemy.
Excuse me. Well, that was easy enough. Pretty difficult. Now let's go back here. Is there anywhere else to explore? Other than there? It doesn't look like. Yep, and then we can build another base here if we so want it. Which we don't really need to. Okie dokie.
You must construct additional.
Yeah, must construct additional pile.
I walk the shadowed path.
Can't be great more. You don't really need to, but we will do it anyway.
Upgrade complete.
Okay, let's destroy this last Zerg base. Oh yeah, I forgot to do that stuff. Okay, let's go attack. With the Colossi in the front. Oh, they have quite a big base here.
Destabilization is nearly finished. The megalith will disembark soon.
That was easy enough. That was only a small base, huh? There. Kill them all. Just a small base doing nothing at all to me, but well, they are there, they need to die. there. Done. Just gotta wait until the megalith reaches the final. Oh yeah, it's going there now. Let's just go there just in case. Let's use this, shall we?
The lock is down and the megalith is traveling.
Oh, whoops.
Stasis grid at 20%.
That's how it works.
Wait.
I didn't know that.
Detecting activity in the Zerg hive nearby. They're reinforcing the last lock.
They're reinforcing the last lock? Okay. Did suddenly new units appear here? Because I already killed off the base here. There's only me now. Well, we check anyway. Sometimes just as the mission brought some new units appear. But it doesn't seem like that happened at all. Did we? False. That was a false message, Karax? I don't remember the name. Karax. Whatever his name is. You will be. You are a traitor. Thank you. Good luck. Whatever. Oh well, just waiting for it to arrive. The megalith. Disciple. Victor. Mentor. Disciple. Master. Mentor, instructor. Oh, depending on how many they kill, they become a title, huh? Sector. Oh, well. Done. I guess this is mission 1. Yep, it was.
The final lock is destabilizing, and the grid is down. We've done it! Cybros is free from stasis.
Recall our forces from Endion's surface. We take this battle to Cybros.
Victory on Unsealing the past, and I managed to do this. GG. Let's continue. We do that later. Yeah.